Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, and today is the last topic, which is an elementary signal, which is the last elementary signal is cosine wave, or you can say simply you can call it as a cosinusoidal wave, and in normal way we called it by a special letter or special name, which is a cos. In simple way, what I'm going to do in today's video, I'm going to find out the Laplace transform of a cos wave, or you can say cosine wave. Now, so let's assume, first of all, this function is a causal. Causal means, I've told you earlier, you can write the function in a causal term or for a causal term. Just simply multiply it by unit step function, or else just mention the time period for t is greater than 0. This function is available only for a t is greater than equal to 0. So you have two choices. If you want to represent any function as a causal function, then simply multiply it by unit step. Otherwise, simply mention the time period, which is a t is greater than equal to 0. That's it. Right now, I have multiplied this by function, a cos function, which is by unit step. So look at it. My function or my signal is x of t is a cos of omega t to u of t. Now, we know the definition of Laplace transform. So x of t can be represented in terms of Laplace transform by x of s. And the formula is, or definition is, product of x of t into e to the power minus st, and integrate this product with respect to time t over the range from minus infinity to infinity. Whereas right now, my x of t is a cos omega t u of t, that I have placed over here. But unit step function is used to represent the function is a causal function. Causal means what? It is available from 0 to infinity. Only right-handed signal, this function is available only in the right-handed signal. That is, this function is transformable in Laplace domain if it is a right-handed signal. But what about left-handed signal? If I consider this function as a left-handed signal, then unit step in the left-hand side having amplitude 0. Amplitude of unit step on the left-hand side is always 0, whereas on the right-hand side, the amplitude of unit step is 1. So, I have substituted limits value according to definition of unit step. I will repeat, unit step is having amplitude 1 only from 0 to infinity. That's why this integration limit starts from 0 to infinity. As I told you in previous case also, in our exams, if unit step function is given and if you want to find out a Laplace transform or a Z transform or a Fourier transform of that function, then unit step is only given, or you can say unit step is always there to change the limit of integration. Now here, the integration limits are changed from minus infinity to infinity. Now it is changes to 0 to infinity. Now, where in this limit the amplitude is 1. Similarly, this A term is also constant, so I will take it outside. In previous videos, we have studied a formula of sine, a complex form of sine, e to the power I theta minus e to the power minus I theta upon 2g. Here also, I am going to substitute the value of a cos function similar to sine wave. Now, a complex form of cos theta is e to the power I theta plus e to the power minus I theta upon 2. Where in sine, we have middle sign is minus and in denominator we have 2i. Here, the cos is a purely real. That's why we have a middle sign is plus and in denominator we have only a 2. So this was the function cos theta is e to the power j theta plus e to the power minus j theta upon 2. I'm going to substitute this value inside the, or we'll replace this cos theta by this value, where this theta is nothing but my omega t. Now look at here, I have taken these two common because it is a constant. And similarly, side by side, I have multiplied c to the power minus t with respect to e to the power j theta. So e to the power j theta multiplied to the power minus st. And this part is now separated because we have a plus sign in between them. And we have studied a Laplace transform property also. You can say that using linearity property, we can solve these terms separately. So I have solved this integration separately where the limits from 0 to infinity, and the product is e to the power j theta into e to the power minus st, whereas in second part we have e to the power minus j theta into e to the power minus st. But right now my theta is omega t, so I'll have replaced all this theta by omega t. Now you can take t common from the brackets, because in both the integration we have exponential term. So you can see that if the bases are same, then powers get added. But after adding this power, I am going to take minus t common. So that's why I have taken minus t common. So just I have written the values. The first values I have written over here, and the second term value I have written first. Now here, if I take minus t common, then in the second part we have minus st minus j omega t. If I take minus t common, then what will get? The both the minus sign taken common, both the terms will become positive. Now look at here. If I take minus t common, then this will be s plus j omega. Now in the previous videos also we have studied different formulas related to integrations, and you know that the different integration of exponential term is exponential term will remain as it is, whereas its coefficient of variable will be mentioned in or written in the denominator. So in this integration the variable is t and the coefficient is minus of into bracket s plus j omega, and in second part the variable is t and coefficient is minus of inside this bracket s minus j omega. So these two part will be now available in the denominator side of both this function. So right now after integrating both the sides, both the functions, what you will get? E to the power minus t s plus j omega upon minus of this term will be in the denominator, that is minus s plus j omega. Similarly on this side also minus of s minus j omega will be in the denominator. Now do the same thing. First of all, limit, substitute the limit. The upper limit will be substituted first and then lower limit. Now if I substitute upper limit, that is minus t, this t is replaced by infinity and this t is replaced by 0. So upper limit minus lower limit. The upper limit is infinity, so e to the power minus infinity is 0, whereas lower limit is 0, e to the power 0 is 1. Now this minus minus sign gets cancelled. Similarly on left hand side also this minus sign gets cancelled. What else is remaining? 1 upon s plus j omega plus 1 upon s minus j omega. Now simply multiply, cross multiply these two values. So what you will get? S minus j omega plus s plus j omega whole divided by s square plus omega square. I have told you this concept of these two functions. If we have a plus b, I am going to consider this j omega as a b. And in second part, if we have a minus b, this j omega is b. Then a plus b in one bracket into a minus b in second bracket. The product is a square minus b square. A square means, of course, I am going to write a s square. But minus b square, this b is j and omega. That is j is nothing but the imaginary term. So a square of imaginary is minus sign. So we know that the formula is a square minus of b square, whereby b is j omega. So this will become j square, omega square and s square. Now we know that the square of imaginary term is minus 1, then this minus sign will be changed to plus. So what I will get? S square plus omega square. Now in the numerator side, you can say that j omega get cancelled. What you will get? Twice of s. Now look at it. Outside this bracket, we have a by 2. And inside the bracket, we have a 2 in the numerator. This 2 gets cancelled. The result of cos omega t is a into s upon s square plus omega square. Now, this is the transformation of cos wave into a Laplace domain. Most important part. If we have a function, a cos of 4t. So just compare this cos of 4t with the statement of this derivation. Before starting this derivation, I have written a cos of omega t. So just after comparing, what you can get? Omega is my 4. If that omega value is 4, then substitute their omega value or replace this omega value by 4. What you will get? S upon s square plus 4 square will be a 16. Now if we have a 2 over here, then this omega is replaced by 2. So likewise, you can transform any values of cos omega t into Laplace domain. Simply, you have to replace omega value whatever omega values are given in question, that you have to substitute over here and take the square of it, which means that function is transformed into a Laplace domain. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe Ekeeda for further more videos. Thank you so much.